When I started to write the paper, I could see, I think it made statements, how valuable it would be to historians to have this kind of information to be able to trace these developments. And today now, even when I work with the HistCite program, when you get this list of the you essentially create a citation index of the field you're looking at. You get this incredible timeline. This is created for you. I mean, you've got a record of everything that historians or whoever has written on that subject have cited, and that gives you some kind of a immediate kind of rough and quick and dirty timeline of the field. No? Now, it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to assign greater importance to the most cited stuff, because what you're looking for is the chronological development of the field. And what Irv and I found in the Asimov thing, there were certain papers that proved to be what we called important links that Isaac Asimov had overlooked, and he agreed that he had overlooked a couple of papers, but not very many. So, and I think that's one of the weaknesses right now in the early stages of SciMate, that unless you apply subjective criteria, you're gonna always overemphasize what gets highly cited versus the appropriate link, And I saw that when I was trying to show, when I did this paper for the Bernal Symposium in Dublin, we showed linkages between J.D. Bernal and Watson and Crick and Rosalind Franklin and other people, but there weren't as many links as I expected to find. But it's just, it turns out to be a very interesting tool to be able to take two people's personal bibliography and just run their two HistCite files together. So you take my record and your record, you run the two together. Who do we cite in common? How are they linked? And
you pointed out that some people have neglected to cite people that they should have,
memory.
Like Watson.
Watson admitted to that eventually, but even Einstein was probably a. I don't know that he forgot. He just didn't formally cite them. Who knows what the reasons were? But he hasn't got very many references in his papers. They're probably implicit. We used to call them the implicit references. So if you were going to trace a genealogical tree of the field, you'd have to go in and add those. We call them pseudo citations.
I think he claimed that he didn't know the literature that well, and he would have cited them if he'd known about.
He didn't know the literature? Einstein.
That's what he said
it?
Back in 1905. He didn't know the
literature. Medawar would have said he was smart to have avoided it, ignored it. he didn't know it, but he'd learned it somehow.
Yeah, he learned it, but he didn't know who
he's got the ideas.